Today is Kingdom Friday, an outreach of Bethel Bible Church to believers who are business owners in the greater El Paso area.
The goal and the desire of Kingdom Fridays is for believers to bless believers so that we can change the face of El Paso.
Each week we will introduce a member of the family of God that is providing a service, edifying the body, and glorifying God. Now let's join the conversation.
Welcome to Kingdom Fridays. This is Bethel Bible's ministry to encourage us in the El Paso area to listen to believers, buy from believers, bless believers. As we interview today, Chris Yeagle, I want you to know that Chris does not come to our church, but what we want to do is to have believers around the city work with believers around the cities. As you hear Chris speak and share, perhaps this is a business or an industry that you would like to connect with. And so welcome, Chris, to Kingdom Fridays of Bethel Bible.
Thank you for having me.
Welcome, Chris.
Thank you.
Chris, tell us a little bit about what you do in the marketplace.
I own a company called Diligent Plans, and our vision is to better the world through developing leaders and teams. I teach leadership and the effects of a high-functioning team. We do basic motivational speaking, like for keynotes. We do classroom-style training. And then we also do what I call controlled adversity, which is immersive events like, for instance, we do rock climbing. Hmm. We'll take a team out to Waco Tanks for 3/4 of a day, and people they've just met before will then be holding the rope that keeps them from falling off the rock. So it's a huge trust-building exercise.
Yeah.
They love it.
And what I'm hearing from you is it's all scripture-based?
Absolutely. In fact, the name itself came from Proverbs 21:5, that says the plans of the diligent lead surely to plenty.
Most businesses and even church environments need help in team building. So I'm sure that there are a lot of people out there that could use your help.
We're going to come back and talk about Diligent Plans. But first we want to know, Chris, where were you in your life when you decided to make Jesus Lord?
I was raised in the church. I grew up in the countryside of Pennsylvania. My parents trained me in the way I should go. They brought me into the church. We were non-denominational, Bible-believing church. So I grew up in the Lord, and then I went into the military when I was 18 and spent about 10 years in the Army. When I was young, I went through the narrow gate, and I went down the path I should. And then for some reason in the Army, I decided, hey, I'm going to try Chris's way. So I backed up out of that gate, and I went on the path that the world takes, and I kind of backslid for maybe 10 or 12 years in my 20s and early 30s.
Yeah, when did you own your faith?
I was at a breaking point in 2013. I was sitting out by a pool, and I had gone this world's way and, you know, the empty promises, made poor decisions, allowed arrogance and some other things to dominate who I was. And it just wasn't fruitful, and it had produced a death in my life, a death of relationships and opportunities and many things. And I was sitting outside of this pool, and I remember looking at the deep end. And for a moment, I had this vision of myself on the bottom of the pool with a rock on my chest.
Oh, my.
And I took ownership of it for about 30 seconds. And then I just had an awakening moment where it was almost like I felt like a slap, like wake up. And my eyes opened wide, and I felt the presence of God just hit me in my heart like a ton of bricks. And this was about noon on a random weekday, and I hadn't shaven forever. And I went in the house, and I cleaned up, and I never went low again. And that was the starting point of me coming back to where I was and surpassing it and making sure that he was at the helm of my marriage, my business, my relationships with my kids and friends and family. And there's no going back. You know, yeah, I learned my lesson. This is an important point I want to make to everyone listening, is the devil, we may think that he's an opportunist, you know, the kind that throws out a banana peel and watches us slip. But he's really not. He can be, but he's also a strategist. And he will wait for years to develop footholds in the strongholds that he's placed in your life. And he won't stop when that initial attack is foiled. So if we overcome the initial attack, he will wait in the backwashes to get you with shame and regret and missed opportunities. And if he can focus our minds on that in the wake of sin, then he will. And now what he's accomplished is not only the years of time that we were subject to the sin, but also the after effects of it. So that's where he tried to get me. He said, oh, you should be ashamed of what you did. And, you know, God doesn't think the same of you anymore. And nobody will ever give you opportunities again. And it was all the Lord of lies. Where I really need to focus, forgive yourself, repent, change your behavior, be transformed by a renewing of your mind.
That's found in Romans 12, too.
So it was in you. You know, the seeds of the word had been deposited, and it was there. And the word of God says, the word of God will not return void.
What made a Pennsylvania young lad come and move to El Paso?
Went to West Point, and after 4 years of that arduous curriculum, I graduated, went in the Army, and I ended up being stationed down here in El Paso at Fort Bliss. Yeah, so I was stationed here for several years as a military police captain in the Army.
Okay. So that's kind of what drew you, and you stayed. So
yeah.
Got a business going and wife and kids. Praise God.
Yeah. And we want to thank you for serving.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah.
How's the family feel about El Paso?
So we have a blended family. We've been married 3 years. My wife's from here originally.
Erica?
We have four kids, all girls, so could use some extra prayer there. just kidding. Yeah, they're a blessing.
That would make you king of the home, then.
King of the home. Absolutely. I have all the ages. 5.
Mila.
6.
Michaela.
12.
Alexandra.
And?
Fabiola.
20. It's great. Girls are great. We love El Paso.
Good.
God has planted us here, and not only in our church, but in business and in our relationships. But I feel peace is here in El Paso. So I know I'm here, and we're here for a purpose. So every day I embrace that, and my family does too.
That's good. We follow that peace, don't we? We have to follow the peace.
We have to, right.
Like you say, the flesh is anxious and wants to do its thing, but the peace is what is our guide. And that we can depend on.
So it sounds like there's all the skill sets that you got in the military, you've kind of incorporated it and using it to bless or help the marketplace develop leaders, develop plans, develop teams.
You know, it's funny. I got out of the military. I went into the corporate world for two stints, 3 to 4 years in project management out in the Dallas-Fort Worth metro.
Okay.
And then I went into medical device sales. At the end of the 3 or 4 years of doing that, I realized that I've been blessed with success across unrelated industries. So the Army, project management, and sales. And I remember sitting down and kind of reflecting on where I'd come to that point. And I realized there were some common threads that enabled me to be successful in different industries. I identified those threads, and I thought, wow, if I could do that, then I can teach those things to other people. And that's when God developed this spirit in my heart to start a company where I teach leadership and the effects of a high-functioning team. And so that's kind of what led me. It was a progression of experience that led me to where I am. And I'm thankful that I found it at the age I did.
Now, do you teach the leadership first or together? How does that work?
Good question. Leader development is our most important function at Diligent Plans because the best teams can be met with toxic leadership, and it just demoralizes and destroys the team. So I like to focus on leaders first. I always ask leadership questions. I know you want me to come in and develop your team, but tell me about your leaders. And then I try to involve them if I feel they need to be trained or worked with individually. I think it's essential.
Following Jesus, our leader becomes so significantly important.
Amen. Amen. I consider my business a ministry. It's based on Jesus telling us that we're the light of the world and the salt of the earth. Mm-hmm. And so by design, I decided to go out into the world. Often find myself in environments that the light is dim. So I hope to bring techniques and methods based on the truth of the word into those places that need the light.
And they can see that calm and that peace and that joy that is immovable. We all have our moments, but all in all, we return to that peace and that peaceful place.
Right.
The Word of God says, he whose mind is stayed on thee, he has peace, right? Mm-hmm. Because we keep our mind focused. We stay vertical.
Chris is a fellow believer and brother in the Lord, and so if you're out there listening and need help with your leadership style or leadership development or teams, we'd encourage you to get in touch with him. Chris, how would they get in touch with you?
The best way is probably through my website, diligentplans.com.
Okay.
That will also lead to social media, Instagram, LinkedIn, Facebook are our primary ones. Also, we're developing a YouTube channel with some content. And
have you done anything locally yet?
I've done work here locally for the city of El Paso, the county of El Paso, Texas Tech. I've done some work at UTEP. I've actually done some work with Johnson & Johnson at some of their factories right across the border. I've been very blessed. I have a team, 10 speakers and trainers all throughout the country, including New York, New Jersey, Philadelphia, and some Midwestern states. So we do have a presence locally and around the country.
Following another model that really worked well, our Lord, who poured himself into 12 and then sent them out. So,
thank you.
Chris, how would you like to speak to the listener? What would you like to say about your business?
One of the attitudes and values we have at Diligent Plans is the mission is more important than the compensation to us. Granted, we get paid and we do well according to the industry standards, but all of us, my whole team, we're in it to make an impact and to make an effect and to walk away knowing that we've instilled values and principles that will continue on long after we get back to our lives. So that's what really drives us. Hmm. Most of my team and myself, we're veterans. A lot of us are retired officers, former officers in the military, and a lot of us have committed to a lifetime of service to the nation. Even though we've hung up the uniform, we've put on a different one, and we continue to serve that way.
And you're a soldier in the army of God.
Amen. Still soldiering.
Still soldiering.
Yeah. Put God on your that. Armor every day.
Every day.
When you train a leader, Chris, do you train in a way that it's going to overflow into the family, into that unit as well?
Oh, man, that's a wonderful question. There's been a belief that I've come across that believes that, you know, when you come to work, you're a different person than when you go home, and that is absolutely incorrect. The two are one and the same. So it is my hope and my desire that what I teach you, you can apply to your families, and you can apply to your friendships, and I hope that you do. You can't be someone at work in front of your team that and a different person at home, nor should you be.
It's the whole life approach, so it certainly sounds very valuable to me.
Yes. The leadership calling is not a popularity contest, and it's not for the faint of heart, but it is a noble calling, and mm-hmm. if undertaken, it can produce great fruit.
Praise God. Yeah. Talking here with Chris Yeagle on Kingdom Fridays. So as we wind up this time, I would like to recommend that you look up Chris Yeagle. Chris, if you would give that information one more time.
My website, diligentplans.com, diligentplans.com. Also, social media, Chris Yeagle on LinkedIn and Instagram, Facebook.
Thank you, Chris, for coming.
Thank you, Chris.
Thank you for having me.